and welcome. Welcome to Math.cm, where you will learn life skills and math skills. So I want to first thank our guests for coming. I see Mr. Carter there. If you're here, just go ahead and light up the chat. Let us know that you are here. All right, so those of you who are watching the replay, big up yourself as well, and you are welcome. All right, so our guest for live stream today is agriculturalist Mr. Vernon Gay, and we are delighted to have him. So, Mr. Gay, please tell us about your background in farming and or agriculture.
Thank you, Mr. Johnson, and good evening, everyone. Maths is very important in agriculture, as it allows for analysis. It helps in efficiencies and increase productivity in all projects. From the numbering of plants, animals, or showing up failures or profitability in projects, maths have its importance. In agriculture, maths is very important in that it helps one to determine how feasible a project is. Farmers who embark on any project without employing mathematical principles will soon fail. These principles are needed to prove any project viable and determine how sustainable it can be. A feasibility study should be done before any project is embarked on. An application of mathematical principles will determine whether funds in hand is adequate to produce the crop, take it to the market, and then to collect for the produce. There must be checks and balances to determine if from the project one is able to pay all the bills and then profit. Only then will any project be feasible or sustainable. Due to the lack of maths employed in many projects, they die before an income is realized. This is serious. This happens on various occasions. In agricultural engineering, maths is needed. In the construction of a farm building, example, poultry house for broilers, say 3,000 birds. This will need a space of 0.75 square foot per bird for these chickens. For 3,000 birds, one will need 3,000 multiplied by 0.75 square foot, which equals to 2,250 square feet capacity. This is needed to adequately house the birds in order to give good returns. Failure to apply mathematical principles might cause a shortage of space, which will cause poor ventilation, that can result in diseases, and there are various diseases that affect broiler chicks. It will also cause cannibalism among the birds. When they are too close, they pick at each other and will continue picking until one dies. It also causes for lack of space for feeding and for drinking water. Also, a host of other problems. This will then cause high mortality and failure in the project in the long run. During the project operations, records must be kept to determine the number of birds that will be taken to the market. Say 2,900 birds reach the market. That means we have a mortality rate of 100. The weight of these birds must be calculated and the price per pound determine the income. The expenditure must be taken from the income to decide if a project is made, if a profit is made, sorry. The expenditure must be taken from the income to decide if a profit is made. Only then can one know if a project is feasible and will be sustainable. If a project is not sustainable, it will not continue for any considerable period. For the development of crops, the same principle is to be applied. Say for a coffee project, the land after being cleared is to be lined out to indicate where each plant is to be placed. The distance between each plant is to be determined, and then the number of plants per acre or hectare be worked out. And so we find, whether we deal with animals or whether we deal with plants, maths is very important in order for us to understand what is taking place in a particular project. For instance, if we are planting coffee, distance is usually 10 feet by 5, which is the optimal space. And for 1 acre at 10 feet by 5 feet space, it will take 872 plants. This is worked out in maths. Given 43,560 square feet in an acre, divided by 50 square feet, which gives approximately 871.2, which will be rounded off to 872. Mathematically, the cost to produce this crop will be determined by applying maths. It will be determined as we prepare and for purchase pegs, 872 pegs, to indicate on the land where each plant will be placed. When this operation is completed, 872 holes should be dug. Manure is to be placed in 872 holes. And a mound be made for each plant. This operation is so important in that the clearing of land and hole preparation determines how long your plant will remain alive. You see, the plants need an early start, and so in this hole, the medium must be rich in fertile soil, so as to have early growth without hindrance. And so the plants themselves will be developed properly. When all this is said and done, and you are ready to plant, there are so many other important factors that maths will be taken in so as to make your project feasible and sustainable. So likewise, the crop begins to produce when approximately 3 years after the plants are mature. The coffee will be reaped. And here is where the importance of bats also come in. The amount of box per acre that is reaped will be carefully tallied. When to determine the amount of coffee that is produced per acre, each plant individually will have to produce optimum. When this is done, the amount of beans or boxes must be calculated to determine the total box per acre for your project. Now, this will say whether or not your project is feasible. This will say whether or not your project will be sustainable. The fact is, if you are not reaping, you will not have the income to generate growth in your project. The cost per box and your final cost will determine your income. And so from this, you will be able to determine whether or not your project is viable.
Yes, Brother Gay. Thank you very much for sharing such extensive and thorough answer to that particular question. You know, as we continue in dialogue, as we continue even in this interview, we want to get the viewers involved. We want you guys who are here to let us know how things are going. Let us know if you are hearing these points, if you understand what Brother God is, Brother Gay is saying. And I really want to thank you guys for coming. Those of you who will watch the replay, do know that you can leave your questions in the comment box below or in the chat to the side if you are here. Just go ahead and let us know what's going on. So, Mr. Gay, just to reiterate, you have shared how the math is used in many, many areas. You spoke about the pegs, trying to see how much space needs to be covered by a certain crop. You looked at the feasibility of someone investing in certain kind of thing, whether it be raising crop, raising some birds, or planting some kind of thing. So the question is, in relation to farming, just shortly now, in relation to farming, what are the benefits of math? Give me a 1 to 2 minute answer. Go right ahead.
Could you repeat for me? I didn't get you clearly.
All right. So I'm asking, in relation to farming, what are the benefits of math? You can just go ahead and enumerate those for us.
Okay. The very first approach is that for any project, you start with maths to determine how many acres or how many hectares, you will start using numbers.
Yes.
To determine the size of your building, you will start using numbers. And so it is, even before you start to do your project, your thoughts are on numbers.
Yes, Brother Gay. You're speaking my language. After all, it's math CN. And like Brother Gay shared earlier, you know, when you sit down and you do your calculation, you can know for sure, almost certainty, the probability is really high that you will or will not be successful. All right, so viewers may be curious as to what sparked your interest in agriculture. Just share with us what sparked your interest in agriculture. Go ahead.
The very first thing is the thought of a project. And right away, you think of the bottom line. There are many people who will plant a fruit crops as a hobby, but anyone doing a particular project, which takes time and effort, looks at the bottom line. So you think about your increase, you think about your profitability, you think about being successful. All of these adjectives deals with numbers. And right away, the thought of working on a particular project ends up giving you the chance to make funds, which is also numbers. The more, the better. And so it is. Anyone doing anything in agriculture thinks about the bottom line. And for you to get there, you will have to start with numbers and end with more numbers.
So it has to add up, right? Is that what I hear you say?
It has to add up.
Yes, yes. You know, sometimes when I pass, I drive certain freeways. For those friends who are in the States or other countries with large fields, maybe wheat or corn, you know, I particularly like to drive, you know, from the eastern end of Jamaica and head to the central region. And I like to see the sugarcane or the pineapples, these rectangular arrays. Yes, I'm speaking of the rows that I see. You know, these things are very, very important. They don't just put them in rows because they want them to be super neat, you know. Mr. Gay, can you expand on this? Can you tell us why certain crops are ordered in rows and what seem to be matrices, rows, and columns? Can you just tell us about that? Just before you share, though, the reason I'm mentioning this, you know, I always like to see, you know, my favorite fruits, you know, in abundance, well organized, you know, well put together. But tell us about why are, you know, things normally ordered like that? What are some of the benefits of doing that kind of thing? Take it away, brother.
If one should take an aeroplane and fly over the cockpit country, everything would be jumbled and a hazard. Yes. If one should drive or fly over a mango orchard,
wow,
a banana field, and as you rightly said, a pineapple field, you would see the crops in orderly dimensions. The main reason for it is that, one, you will be able to determine how many plants, or you will be able to maximize the amount of plants per acre when it is organized as to when it is planted randomly.
Mercy.
Another important fact.
But again, don't forget your point there. So are you telling me that the order helps you to estimate and to project further to confirm what you did in the feasibility study? Is that a little tiny bit of what you're saying as well?
Yes, it is certain. It is certain. You'll be able to maximize your land use by doing simple, just that. Then again, there are so many other advantages. One would be able to walk through the field with more or less problems as to navigating himself or herself around the plants. One would be able to go through using the intervals, whenever you are going to fertilize, whenever you are going to spray, whenever you are going to reap, whenever you are going to prune, whatever the situation is, it makes the farm more accessible, and the operations can be done with much ease. And this is very important. This also determines the productivity of your project.
Yes, yes, definitely. I know we love to hear about productivity, especially when you are investing. Ms. Carter in the chat just shared that profits, this is one of the reasons, why these things are done so orderly. All right, so just annexed to the question I asked, you spoke about agricultural design. You spoke about land planning, right? Which are very, very important for productivity. But just before we go on there, as you spoke, my mind went to calculus. When we in calculus, those of you who will study math, past college algebra, or past, CXE math, or the even 12th grade math, depending on what you're doing. Those of you who would pass that level in math and you would go up further, you may be treated. By the way, you are treated to this at lower levels as well. So you will actually be treated to things like optimization. This is actually a beautiful topic that is studied in math. And you heard Brother Gay share how, these rectangular arrays can be used to estimate and forecast, and also have more wonderful use than simply to forecast, even though that's very big. What am I talking about? All right, so the optimization in calculus. Consider this problem. Those of you who want a math challenge, you could actually play back this question and actually try to do it. Here it goes. A farmer has 2,040 feet for fencing and wishes to fence off two separate fields. One of the fields is to be a rectangle with length twice as long as the width, while the other field is to be a square. Determine the dimensions of the fields if the farmer wishes to maximize the total area of the field. So what I've read to you is that, fairly nice problem that many would do in calculus. It's under the topic optimization, all right? And so in relation to what I've shared in this problem and reference to calculus, is this problem one that relates to any kind of math that you would have seen in agriculture, Brother Gay? Go ahead and tell us. And if you have seen such kind of problem, tell us what's the approach that is used in a practical sense to solve this problem. If not, let us know as well. Go ahead.
If you're going to fence this area, it simply means you are going right around. And so the distance right around can be measured. It would be two times the long side, two times the short side. I might not get you as clear as I thought. Could you repeat?
Oh, sure, sure. What I'm saying is the kind of problem I describe, the kind of problem that I describe where, a farmer wants to optimize his crops. He wants to probably say plant pineapples, and he may want to plant some sugarcane, but he wants a certain ratio. He wants to maximize his
is years. Is this kind of situation, have you faced any kind of situation like this where you use some kind of math, or how would you tackle such a thing as an agriculturist?
Okay. Thank you. It is a common thing when one is planting coffee, a shade tree is usually planted, sometimes indigrapha, sometimes albizia, which were important trees for the plant in that it fixes nitrogen in the soil just by nature. And apart from giving shade, it gives also nutrient to the plants. In planting coconuts, people would go through and plant plantains, bananas, that will stay there and assist in the income of the farm until the coconut becomes economically viable. You see, coconuts will take 3 to 5 years to be viable economically, even though earlier you might have a crop. And so it is. Within these larger areas, you are able to put a particular plant. Within the coffee, not in the space, but between the plants, but along the row, you can put your shade trees, maybe about 30 feet apart. And so it does not affect even the very row that you walk through or drive through for mechanical operations. And so the area is maximized and you have benefit from both plants. Thank you.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you, Brother Gay. Thank you for such a very, very nice answer. And you definitely show us the practicality, underscored one more time, of why these things are done. Now, I know that ratio and proportion, mixtures and mixing, also rely heavily on unit conversion used in many different ways. I know that it's used so much that for farmers, there are some nice handy booklets or apps that persons can go and just do their conversions really quickly. So here's the question now. Tell us your experience with these as they relate to math in agriculture. That is unit conversion and farming application. Go ahead and share a little bit about that with us. By the way, a viewer, I see Ms. Johnson, Francine Johnson, she actually says very interested. So big up yourself, Ms. Francine Johnson. Thanks for coming. All right, go ahead, Mr. Gay. Take it away.
Yeah, thank you. It is very important in the case of planting crops. One might be given an area, whether in hectares or in acres, and you have to determine vice versa how many plants you would put in per acre, how many plants would you put in per hectare. You would have to just use a given figure as to the amount of meters, square meters per hectare, or the amount of square feet per acre.
and you will do your calculations then. They are usually formulas. And we must understand that formulas are not just put there, but formulas are really practical, workable instruments. And so it's just not a matter of picking it out, but it's a matter of knowing exactly how it can be applied.
Yes.
And once you get that, you are on your way to do your conversion. Thank you.
Thank you very much. You know, sometimes when I teach my 9th or 10th or, you know, even upper grades as well, and we do our review unit conversion, I'm quite sure if they're watching, or anyone doing that kind of thing is watching, they can really see the value there. Thank you for sharing that with us. I see one, Mr. Kevin Beckford, that joined us. He said, I have to be more precise in the farming process. You are adding benefit, Mr. Gay. Our listeners are taking note. thanks for your comment, Brother Beckford. I see. Yes, good evening. Good evening, sir. All right, Brother Gay.
Yes, sir.
We know that while yields can be multifold, sometimes farmers and agricultural engineers must secure loans. Yes, they must go to the bank, you know? And for some, they have to take large sums for some growing seasons. Please explain on this aspect of farming. Listeners, the reason I'm asking agriculturist Mr. Gay this particular question is because he has some experience in this area. So go ahead, Mr. Gay, take it away.
It is very important that a feasibility study is being prepared. This will determine, before a single plant is put in the soil, or before a young bird is bought, using mathematical principles, you should be able to tell the banker or to persuade the banker that based on the principles you apply mathematically, your project will be not only viable, efficient, but also sustainable, so that you'll be able to, over the period of time, repay your loan with interest and your project continue to go on. If at the end of your repayment, the project ends and you have nothing to see in your pocket, it simply means that you would have failed, because the purpose of any project is to make certain that you are better off at the end of such project. And so it is. A study is necessary to show how much it will cost to do all the operations, to take care of all the materials, and in the end, to sell your crop. I have had an experience once with a very important and large farmer who planted coffee, and the trees were grown so tall that the berries started to fall. I went to him and I said, you need to do something about this. There is an operation called cutback, or resuscitation, where you can get the trees after a short period to start producing at optimum within a shorter period than when it is planted. And the crops that fall to the ground would not be there. It would be dollars in your pocket. The farmer was upset, but he went home and he took thought of what I said. The following day he said to me, when I came back here and look at the dollars under the tree, I decided I will cut back my coffee. I resuscitate the coffee. And the thing about it, he had over 60 acres of coffee and he started to cut back all one time. I had to caution him and said, no, you need to make certain that you have what is called a steady income, which is able to maintain each portion of the crop until everything is back in optimum production. I was pleased when he said, I recognize that the figures, the dollars are not in my pocket, but under the tree, and I want it in my pocket. And so there are so many things you can do to encourage or to prove that mathematics is very important. Because when you calculate and when you look at maybe individual small trees and you can compute that to dollars, it makes a difference.
Wow. Thank you. Wow. Brother Gay, it seemed like you know how to cultivate the money tree. Yes, yes. It sounds good. You mentioned the coffee, and we are currently in Jamaica, and we know about the Blue Mountain coffee. Now, I want it to be clear that coffee is a stimulant. And when you use stimulants, you borrow tomorrow's energy. So you have to be careful. Be he wise. I had to share that, right? So, but of course, I know that God had made every plant for some use. And I'm quite sure those precious beans have some good use. We're not going to enumerate all the benefits and use, but this particular thing here, those beans, you need to study them out. Study them out. All right. So, viewers, if you have not already subscribed to MathCN, go ahead and do so. And at the very least, whether you are subscribed or not, go ahead and click the like button. It's just below. It's the thumbs up. This will enable YouTube to share our content so others can enjoy as well. And so, Mr. Gay, I have some students, or had some students. In other words, some students may be listening who may take the CSEC math exam, the CAPE math exam, even this school year. You know, sometime they just settle with the idea of wanting to pass the CSEC or the CAPE or even, you know, other exams. It's like the math portion of SAT or the ACT or whatever you do in your country. Maybe you could type in the chat, what secondary math exam do you do in your country? Whether you are Jamaican, whether you are American, it doesn't matter where you're from. Just go ahead and type something in the chat for us. Let us know what kind of exam do you do. This will be for you. So the question is, what can you say to someone who is just settling with just wanting to pass math at whatever level they're doing? What would you say to them as an agriculturalist and banker who have seen math from many perspectives? Go ahead.
I would say math is very important. And if you just want to pass math, you are going to find out that after passing math, you will start to understand the importance of math. You will need this everywhere you go. Since we started this program this evening, so much is being spoken of. But did you look at the time we spent so far? It might be one of the most insignificant aspects of this evening's program. But the amount of hours, the amount of minutes, the amount of seconds that we used are all calculated. And that is the simplest thing we can ever think about presently. But you will appreciate math and its use when you get your result. Maybe you got one or you got two grades. You may get a 95%. All of this is math. And so you will recognize that even though the fact is just to pass math, it is very important that you take it seriously because you will need it to use throughout your life, every single day. And so passing math, don't let it be just because you want to pass, because certainly you are going to need it as you go day by day. Thank you.
Yes, Brother Gay, you have taken it home. You know, this is the point. Whatever you're doing, whether math, English, or true science, I say true science, whatever you're doing, do all with all your might. There's actually a text in the greatest book that speaks to this. Whatever thy hands find to do, do it with all your mind. When you take this principle and apply it, you will be benefiting. You will be benefiting. If you are in the chat and you know that diligence pays, go ahead and type it in the chat. And those who will watch it in the replay, go ahead and type diligence pays, if you know what I'm talking about. All right, I see Mr. Hilton saying, yes, sir. That's right. And so, you know, whatever your hands find to do, do it with all your mind. And when you do this with math, don't worry about whether you will forget. Don't worry. The brain is very powerful. I'll actually put a link in the description right up here that will show you a little bit about the brain, some of its laws, and your brain will expand in very nice proportion. You have to cultivate your brain. Yes, you have this wonderful resource, and the math you learn will actually help you to unlock many, many things. And so You have certainly seen math from different perspectives, Mr. Gay. What words of caution would you give a high school student, a college student, a teacher, an administrator, even a general worker, and also a farmer, when it comes on to adopting the mindset that math is hard for no reason? I hope this is not the position of anyone right now, but tell us what you think about this. Give us that word. Give us that word of caution. Take it away.
Each of us will certainly need to use math throughout our lives. If you shy away from it, you are going to be caught up one day with the need to use it. If you shy away from math, one day you will have to pay for someone to do for you the very thing you could have done if you had approached it with an open mind. There are so many persons today who are literally illiterate when it comes to maths. And it cost them so much. Sometimes it costs your business. Someone swindles you out of your business because you were unable to pick up the red flags that were waving at you, all because you failed to show appreciation for maths and failed to see the importance of maths. Maths is very, very important. And we should all seek to use our potentials to gather as much as possible as far as maths is concerned. Thank you.
Yes, thank you very much, Brother Gay. Thank you so much. You know, in the chat, I see Sister Carter saying diligent space. Yes, Brother Hilton underscored that point as well. So did Kevin, Mr. Beckford there. He actually underscored that point. And also, I see a very nice comment from Ms. Johnson there. Big up you guys self, you know. I really appreciate you guys coming. I really appreciate your coming. And don't be afraid to share the link. It will still be available here after. All right, so viewers, this is your time now. You can ask your question. Go ahead and type your question for Mr. Gay or for myself in the chat. If you're watching the live, the replay, go ahead and type it in the description below. So go ahead and share. Do you have any questions? Share them now so we can answer. Go ahead and share those questions. You know, Brother Gay, while the viewers work on their question, I must say one more time that I truly appreciated, excuse me, I truly appreciate you coming on tonight. I really, really do. You know, anybody in the chat have anything they would like to share regarding this live stream, just go ahead and share that. Oh yes, one more time, just smash that like button if you actually enjoyed this particular live stream. When you press it, it should be darkened. It should not be white like before. All right, so thanks again. Brother Gay. What math advice would you give? I believe I asked you this before, but I think I asked you this before, but you can reiterate in 30 seconds or less. What math advice would you give to anyone? Just reiterate that one more time for me, and then we'll see if any questions come in. Go ahead.
Today is the 30th of December, 2021. It has a whole lot to say to us. Digitally, we would say it is a 12, 30, 21. Or in Jamaica, we would say the 30 of the 12, 21. With just a dot in between these figures, it says a lot. That is math, that's numbers. It indicates something very important, something special. And so as we go through life, we're going to see, especially living in a digital world, we are going to see figures which have meaning just not just as you see them, but they imply something that is important. So likewise, math, we are going to be seeing much in just figures, and we need to decipher them. Unless you show interest in maths, you will not be able to do the same. Show interest, optimize your ability to make certain that you are in the position that you might find yourself later on, you are able to see yourself through by applying yourself today to maths. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very, very much. Thank you very, very much. All right. So I saw a question in the chat. There was a question there from Ms. Carter. She asks, peas are short-term crops. Can you name a few more short-term crops? All right, just go ahead and answer that question for Ms. Carter. She said, peas and thanks. I love it. Go ahead.
Did you say short-term promise?
Short-term crops.
Crops, okay. Crops. All right, I didn't get it clear. Short-term crops. In Jamaica today, one short-term crop that is very viable is the sorrel. Sorrel originally was something that was used during the Christmas festive season. Today, sorrel is used as a regular drink throughout the year. It is very, very expensive, and it is very nutritious. And you will be able to reap sorrel after planting 3 months down the line. It's one of the shortest crop that you can put in, which is very, very viable. There is another one, corn. Corn is a crop that takes approximately 3 months also. And it's very expensive. If you are able to sell green corn, we see so many people boiling corn on the street side. When you go to the large restaurants, it is there also. And it takes only 3 months after planting to come to maturity. 3.5 months, you should be able to check in to see how much profit you make if you plant any of those two crops. They are not only short crops, but they are very viable and they are lucrative on the market. Thank you.
Yes, Brother Gay. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you very, very much. All right, so those of you who are in the States and in the summer, take a trip to the Walmart and see the corns and the price thereof. You know what I'm talking about. However, Mr. Gay speaks of corn in Jamaica. It is indeed expensive. You know, sometimes I see the corn for, is it $1,200 per dozen? That's 12. So $100 each. And this is quite a lot. Bear in mind that the math comes to play in a term called purchasing power parity. Look it up. Check it out. And just one more thing for those who watch from overseas. Another name for sorrel is Jamaica hibiscus. This is what it's called in some places as well. All right. So thanks again, Brother Gay, for sharing. And do you have any final words, Brother Gay? Go ahead and share your final words for us tonight. Take it away.
Maths is deemed very important in agriculture, in all its forms. As in other business, the principle of math is well needed for the control and smooth running of all its operations. Agriculture can be very rewarding when maths is used. This will make the business more efficient and productive, rendering it viable, sustainable, and profitable. Maths should always be incorporated in any project, especially in agriculture, for you to make it a viable business and live from its proceeds. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Brother Gay. All right, so to the viewers who have questions still, who have not received an answer, just know that I will put an answer in the comments below. Those of you who are watching the replay, don't be afraid to put your answers there as well. I will be certain to get a reply for you. So thank you one more time. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.
Thank you.
Right there. Okay. Brother Gay. Yes.
Yes, Brother Johnson.